All right, disturbing new details emerging this morning about the school shooting in Perry, Iowa that left a sixth grader dead and several others hurt. So a TikTok shared on social media, believed to be from the 17-year-old shooter, shows him posing in a school bathroom before he opened fire. We're also learning more about the victims, who include Perry High School's principal who was hurt. Dan Merberger's daughter says he tried to distract and stop the shooter by talking to him. Veronica Miracle is in Perry, Iowa with the latest for us. Veronica.
Well, John, this community is just in mourning over the sixth grader who was killed. Also, the other people who were injured. Five other people were injured, four students and one staff member. All of the injured are expected to survive. But the staff member, the principal of Perry High School, identified by his daughter on Facebook as Dan Marburger, had to go into surgery. He is in stable condition. His daughter also saying in that post that her father tried to help save lives, saying, quote, he tried to approach and talk Dylan, the shooter, down and distract him long enough for some students to get out. As many of you know, Dad, he is a gentle giant, an amazing dad, an amazing person. This is a very small community, John. The entire school district has only about 1,800 students, so everyone knows everybody. Last night at a vigil, CNN spoke to a woman who says she knows the boy who was killed. Take a listen.
A friend of ours, basically like my second kids, his friends, and had heard that he was missing and he lives in our neighborhood. So I went to ask and heard from the family themselves. And he really is just the sweetest boy, the one you want your kids to be friends with.
So heartbreaking. Now, what's front and center for investigators is a motive. They're trying to figure out why exactly this happened. They're looking at social media posts from before that the shooter posted before the shooting, as well as around the time of the shooting on TikTok, posting from inside a bathroom inside the school with the caption, "Now we wait." And we're also learning from two students who spoke with ABC News that bullying may have been a factor in this shooting, saying that they believe he was bullied since elementary school. Take a listen.
He got tired of the bullying. He got tired of the harassment.
We tried to be there when he needed us, which clearly we weren't there for him enough.
The 17-year-old shooter died from a self-inflicted gunshot injury. John.
The shooter is believed to have posted on social media in the moments before the attack at the high school that killed a sixth grader and wounded five others, including the school's principal. Now, a new study out today by Everytown for Gun Safety says 300,000 lives could be saved in the next decade if states adopted gun laws like those in California and New York, which are some of the strictest in the country. CNN's Omar Jimenez joins us now. Omar, what does this report say?
Yeah, John. So this study from Everytown, the gun violence prevention nonprofit, essentially looked at the state gun death rates and compared them with the strength in gun laws as we look state by state, and came up with a score and a ranking for these. So some of those top states: California, New York, Illinois, again, a composite score of strength in gun law, but also matched up with the gun death rate. And what's interesting is New York and California actually had some of the lowest gun death rates in the country, despite having some of the strictest gun laws, even though they have two of the biggest cities in the country. And gun deaths includes homicides, suicides, and accidental killings as well. On the other side of the spectrum, Arkansas scored the lowest by Everytown standards because of its weak gun laws and high gun death rates. Now, Everytown used essentially five foundational laws here to sort of judge strength in a state's, you know, gun laws or policies. So those, you're seeing them on your screen there: requirements for background checks, permits for concealed carry, secure firearm storage, rejection of stand your ground laws, and extreme risk laws that temporarily remove firearms access. They also looked at other metrics, but those were essentially the five foundational ones. And so based on the potential implementation of those laws, they believe that nearly 300,000 lives could be saved over the next decade if every state put in place the gun laws that we've seen in some of their top ranked states. And that's based on what they found in this state, which lines up with, in this study, which lines up with previous versions, that they find that a state's strength in gun laws is directly correlated with lower gun death rates. And there are a number of states that have put in place gun violence prevention bills over the last year. The question is, and what this study pushes for the idea of, is whether some of those gun violence prevention laws that recently passed will lower the state gun death rates in the coming years.
Well, obviously, we'd like to see those rates go down no matter what. Omar Jimenez, thank you very much.
Of course.